Oh, I've got a good one today. All right. We have a column that has date and time, and we want to split that into date and then time. And I knew this was going to be simple, but now I'm second-guessing myself. A neighbor of mine went on a job interview. Hiring manager loves pivot tables, wants to make sure this person can do pivot tables. They had them do a hands-on test. A, can you build a pivot table? How to report by date instead of date and time? And then limit the report to class equals one and the day is Tuesday or Thursday. Ooh, that makes it really hard. Okay, so my initial reaction was we have to attack number two first, right? And I showed the person how this date and time, if we go into show formulas mode, is really a serial number date, the number of days elapsed since January 1st, 1900, and then the time is the fraction of the day after that decimal point. And so I said, you know, it's two weird formulas, but to get the date, we're gonna take A2 and we're gonna truncate it or take the integer of it, so equal int of A2, and that may not be formatted correctly. So we have to come up here and change it to a short date. And then to get the time, now that we already have the date, it's just simple, it's A2 minus D2. Definitely won't be formatted correctly, but we can come in here and format that as a time. And so now we have it broken out that the date is there and the time is there. And now we're free to go create that pivot table. Okay, but then it's just weird that they asked for question one, can you build a pivot table? And then how to report by date instead of date and time. And now I'm starting to wonder if what they wanted the person to be able to do would be to build the pivot table first, insert pivot table, go ahead, go to a new worksheet, put the dates down the left-hand side, and they're gonna show up as date and time, and then, you know, whatever we're gonna put in the values area. And then we can, with the first date or that heading selected, either one, come here and group field and say we wanna group it to just days. Right, that's a very clever way to take that time and just remove it, right? So if we click OK, then we get a new field called days date, which is just the dates and the times are gone. What do you think? Is that what they were looking for? Or were they trying to do some Power Query where we take this data, make it into a table with Control T, and then data from table or range, and then in Power Query, we can come here under transform and say that it's just a straight date. All right, that will remove the times, and now we're free to create our pivot table, home, close and load, close and toad, close and load to, and we're gonna create a pivot table report. And then the date field will automatically be the date. So there's a couple of different ways to go. And I guess if it wasn't for question number three, limit the report to class equals one and day is Tuesday or Thursday. See, that Tuesday or Thursday, that makes this a real pain, right? Because then I need to somehow get the weekday out of this. And I know we have the weekday function, but I actually hate using weekday because I can never remember, what the returns are. It's like one is Sunday, so like later, am I ever gonna remember that that means that two is Monday, three is Tuesday, so I need the threes and the fives to get the Tuesdays and Thursdays. This is just too confusing to me. So what I always do is I use the equal text function of that date, and I ask for it in DDDD format. You could also use three Ds there if you wanted the abbreviation, and that will give you the day of the week. All right, see, now that I have date, time and weekday, now if we create a pivot table, insert pivot table, click OK, we can put the totals here in values, we can, put the dates down the side, classes across the top, and then add a slicer in, and then add a slicer for weekday and class, click OK, and we'll choose Tuesday, and then control click on Thursday, that'll get us just the Tuesday and Thursday dates, and then what was the class? Class is equal to one, so So just one there. And so there's our answer of the 9,064. Yeah, so what do you think for all my regular viewers out there? What if you were heading into an interview and you got these questions, how do you think that they are trying to limit the report by date instead of date and time? Do you think that they're trying to see if you know these formulas to get the integer of A2, or do you have a better way to get the date? And then for reporting by weekday, or at least getting just the Tuesdays and Thursdays, would you use the text function here or something else? Let me know down in the YouTube comments. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.